Well, congratulations, you did it. You've made it to the 10th step of this 10-step tutorial. As I mentioned at the start, XD is all about designing and sharing user experiences at the speed of thought. Let me quickly take you through all of the ways you can share and validate the work that you've done. We covered the desktop preview feature earlier on in this tutorial, and as you might recall, I accessed it from the upper right-hand corner here. In addition to being able to interact with my prototype and see any changes I make on the design canvas live in the desktop preview, I can also record my interactions to save out as an MP4 file and share that. I would do that using the record icon here in the upper right-hand corner. This is also true of the mobile preview feature with the icon here just to the left of the desktop preview feature. By downloading the XD app for either Android or iOS and then connecting that device by way of USB, I can have that same live preview and same interactive experience right there on my mobile device directly. When you're ready to take the next step, you can share your designs live on the web by way of the Publish Prototype. When I click on the Share icon, I can select Publish Prototype. I have the ability here to come in and create a title for my design. I can decide if I want to protect it by way of a password and assign that password, and then simply come in and create a public link. Once that link has been created, I can share it with others by just copying it to the clipboard using the Copy Link icon. I can also preview it directly in the browser by clicking on the Open in Browser icon. If I'd like even greater security, I can create what's known as a private link. The private prototype feature allows me to limit exactly who gets to see that prototype by inviting them using their individual email. Now, one point worth mentioning, when you create a prototype, XD will only include the artboard's link to the home artboard you defined. This allows you to have many artboards in your overall project, yet limit what you share to the current flow of your choosing. Now, once the design is fully validated and I'm ready to hand it off to my developer, I'll want to select Publish Design Specs here from the Share menu. This will once again upload only the artboards attached to my home artboard, but it allows me to include additional information for my developer. I can export for a particular destination, web, iOS, or Android, and in doing so, I can include the specific assets that I want that developer to be able to extract from my design. Once I publish that design spec, I can share that link with my developer. They in turn can log into a web browser, and they have their own unique experience. Notice I can see the two artboards that I've shared and that they're linked to one another by rolling over one of those artboards. Clicking on that artboard and then clicking on individual items allows my developer to see exact measurements of how I've placed each of my individual design elements in the artboard. Clicking off the artboard brings up a number of specifications for my developer here on the right-hand side, including screen details, the ability to download individual assets at a variety of file formats and resolutions, colors in use, and any character styles that I have. Now, obviously, there's a great deal going on with Adobe XD. I hope you've enjoyed this introductory tutorial and that it's the beginning of a long relationship with the application.